The rule number two. The oxidation number of all monoatomic ions equals the charge on the ion or the element. The oxidation number, rule number two, the oxidation number of all monoatomic ion equals the charge of the elements. The oxidation number of all monoatomic ion, mono here means one. That means it's a single ion, single element in ionic form. For instance, if I say Na plus, if I say Mg2 positive, if I say Al3 positive, these are monoatomic ion. If I say O2 negative, this is one element here, this is one element, but they have charges. The difference between them to this, here there is no charge, they become neutral, but here there are charges. So anytime you have one element, but that element has a charge, the oxidation number is the charge that that particular element carries. In this case here it is plus one, the oxidation number here is plus one, here the oxidation number is plus two, the oxidation number here is plus three, the oxidation number here is minus two. That is how you can get the oxidation number of that particular species in that case. We shift to other points. Now that the oxidation number, we try to get oxidation number for the elements that we discussed a few minutes ago. The oxidation, we have the right now to say that the oxidation number of oxygen is minus two. Except in peroxides. And what are these peroxides? E.g., when you have Na2O2 peroxide, you have H2O2. These are the peroxides. Apart from peroxide, anytime you see oxygen, the oxidation number is equal to minus two. But when they are in peroxide, except in peroxide, where it is minus one, So what I'm saying in short is the oxidation number of oxygen, wherever you look at oxygen, is minus two. Except in peroxide, there is an exception here, whatever way you look at it. The oxidation number for oxygen is not always minus two. But it becomes minus one when you are dealing with peroxide, like Na2O2, H2O. You can look at other examples for peroxide if the time deem it necessary. Now what we are looking at, that wherever you see oxygen, the oxidation number becomes minus two, except when it is in peroxide. Here you are now seeing oxygen here. You don't have the right to put minus two here. You don't have the right to put minus two here because they are peroxide. We put minus one. But apart from them, wherever you see oxygen, like if you see CaCO3, this one is not a peroxide. The oxidation number for oxygen becomes minus two. But anytime you see peroxide, you put minus one for the oxidation number of oxygen. We go to other phase. That can be in terms of hydrogen. Now we are going to the other rule, and that particular rule is dealing with the case for the oxidation number of hydrogen. We have looked at a case for the oxidation number of oxygen, which I said is always minus two, with the exception of peroxide, where it becomes minus one. Now we go to rule number four. The oxidation number, you have the right to say the oxidation number of hydrogen. Now we have dealt with oxygen, we now look at hydrogen. The oxidation number of hydrogen is plus one. The oxidation number of hydrogen is plus one, except there is also an exception here, except in hydrides. Example of the hydride is when you have a metallic sodium reacting with that hydrogen. Metallic element combining with that hydrogen becomes the hydride form. But if that is not the case, the oxidation number of hydrogen is plus one. But when they now occur in hydride, the oxidation number, where the oxidation number becomes minus one. So the oxidation number of hydrogen, wherever it is plus one, except in hydride, where it is NaH, like NaH here as an example, sodium hydrogen, gradually when the hydrogen combines there, or metallic element combining with hydrogen, where the oxidation number is no more minus one. I can cite an example here. If I have now like H2SO4, here the oxidation number for hydrogen here become plus one. The oxidation number for hydrogen here become plus one. But when you now look at NaH, the oxidation number becomes minus one. That is the case we want to look at here for it to be clear. We go to rule number five. Rule number five says, when you now have a compound, you have a compound that has both a mentor and no mentor. The mentors always have positive oxidation number and the no mentors have negative oxidation number equal to their valencies. I will write that and go over it. Mentors carry positive. Mentors carry positive oxidation number. Mentors carry positive oxidation number. And no mentors carry negative oxidation number equal to their valency. Now, when you look at this statement, it's a case in which a mentor and a no mentor they combine. For instance, we can get sodium chloride, in which the sodium here happens to be the mentor. The sodium here happens to be the mentor, so the oxidation number for the sodium will always be positive value, and the no mentor becomes negative. So the mentors will always carry the positive oxidation number, and the no mentor carries the negative oxidation number. But all of this one will be equal to their valency. For instance, the valency for sodium is one, so the oxidation number here becomes plus one. The valency for chlorine is one, but we will not write one, we write minus one. Why? Because chlorine happens to be a no mentor. So we write the positive values for all mentors and we write negative values for